تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Because the time is short, we go quickly. والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله, it's very big honor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this mosque in this city. It's a huge mosque, and from outside it looked like a fortress. Yeah. Alhamdulillah, that is another place for Muslims to find what they like and what they love. Everyone in life, let us focus, be very short and very to the point. Everyone in life has a symbol and has a hope and must have a someone that guide him. And today, with the new generation, we see that people around the world, every child of our children, I'm saying it, all of us must be more than 95% of Muslims today. Their children, they have in their mind a heroic personality, someone that they focus on, someone that they feel they are happy with. And that is an important point in the Muslim way of looking at things. Every one of our children has a hero, and their heroes are Hollywood stars. Their heroes are Superman, or Spider-Man, or Catman, or Snake Man. I don't know if there is a Snake Woman also, but Mermaid, and PlayStation, GameCube, I don't know what else. And don't tell me no, which is correct. So everyone looks for a hero. So you gave them, or they have been given the opportunity to have a hero. Because this is the nature, our nature, the nature of how we are being created, to have a hero. If we don't have a hero in our life, a symbol, someone that is there, that we look at, we cannot understand, we lose the understanding of our ways or understanding of what is our personality, because everyone feels that he needs something to follow, to imitate. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a hero, has given us a leader, has given us the most perfect symbol for humanity. And we are trying to hide it from our children. Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah are strongly supporting that. The others are trying to bring that down. And Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, unfortunately, they don't have the power. They don't have the oil money. They don't have the finance to keep building up the personality that they love and their children love. You must bring the heroism of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the love of your children. We have to build them up. And that's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in his famous hadith, "Man ahya sunnati faqad ittaba'ani wa man ittaba'ani faqad ahabbani." He said, who revived my sunnah, because Prophet knew that at the end of these days, of this world, no one going to revive the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sunnah is going to be down. The love of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not going to be anymore respected. He knew that. He predicted that. Where the love to Prophet today? There is no love to Prophet except in this small mosque around the world, that of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, which they have no power. So our hero, that it has to be our goal, is been expressed to us. Allah showed him to us. He is the seals of messenger. Did we make anything to our children to respect and to love that hero? I was in New York one day, and I asked someone who invited me to his house, a Muslim, very Muslim, well-known person, give charities to mosques. He invited me to his house. It was Christmas time. And it's, you know, it's a vacation. So he invited me to his house. I went there, I was surprised. I saw Christmas tree there. I said, what is this? He said, oh, don't bother with that. It's for the kids. I said, okay. Well, they are happy celebrating Sayyidina Isa's birthday. It's okay. But why they are happy to celebrate Sayyidina Isa's birthday, not happy to celebrate Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birthday? I said, can I speak with your children? He said, yes. There were a lot of ulama. Not one of them said one word, because they are Wahhabi ulama. I'm not afraid from Wahhabi, so don't worry about it. So they were there sitting. I'm sorry if the masjid will criticize me later. So they came and I asked them, what is this? They said, this Christmas tree. For what? For Jesus' celebration. When is Jesus' birthday celebrated? 25th of December. It's correct. I said, who is your prophet? They were looking, not answering. And the father said, say Muhammad. They said, Muhammad, without saying Sayyidina wa Nabina, Sayyidina Muhammad. That's why he said, man ahya sunnati faqad ittaba'ani. وَمَنْ اتَّبَعَنِي فَقَدْ أَحَبَّنِي. Who revived my sunnah, he follows me. إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah is saying to Prophet, if you, to the Ummah, if you really love Allah, follow Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Let him be our hero for our children. Let them give this perception of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Not making Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a normal person, as they make him, he came, delivered the message and left and finished. No, he is living in our hearts. He said, Ana hayyun tariyun fi qabri. I am soft alive, fresh alive in my grave. Imam Suyuti said, when anyone, because the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whoever sends salam to me, Allah sent back my soul, I will send salam back to him. Wow. Means he is always responding on people around the world and 24 hours responding to their salams. Wow. Means he is fresh. Imam Suyuti said that's an evidence that he is alive in his grave. It's not a grave, it's Rawdatu min Riyad al-Jannah, it's a palace. So I said, well, who is your prophet to these children? They said, they don't know. They said, then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I said, okay, what is his birthday? They don't know. They know Sayyidina Isa's birthday. They don't know Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's birthday. So this is the problem today. And we have to try to fix that problem by keeping supporting and bringing our children to the love of Sayyidina Muhammad and to revive the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Man ahya sunnati faqad ittaba'ani. Who revived my sunnah, he is following me. If Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wants us to follow him, means we are following haqq. Means if we do 2 rak'ats of sunnah or 4 rak'ats of sunnah before the fard, that is the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we use a siwak, that is the sunnah of Prophet. If we put a ring in our right hand or in our hands, it's a sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are going to be rewarded for it, and you are not feeling it. If you leave your bed, it's the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So there are many sunnahs that we are not doing them, then how we are saying that we are followers of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he say من أحب من اتبع من أحيا سنتي فقد اتبعني. You cannot revive one sunnah and leave the rest. But try as much as you can. We are not going to say do all of them. No one can do all of them. But try to do as much as you can. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invited Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, if we want to work it, to speak it in a new world today, we say it is an open invitation to the divine presence, an open invitation in the night of Isra and Mi'raj to Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to reach Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna. People ask, what is Kaaba Qawsayn aw Adna? You know it better than everyone. Two bows of an arrow and less. Two bows of an arrow is what? Is two arms. And he said less. Allah said in Holy Quran, aw adna. Aw adna means less than two bows of an arrow. How much adna was not specified. Means can be even 1 inch, isn't it? 1 millimeter even. We don't know how much Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so near. We don't know. And Allah said, "Adna, as much as you think can be near, he was near." That's why if we revive his sunnah, we will be near him, near our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And our Prophet is in the level of nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he raised his name with his name. It's not nice only to put a frame here and showing written on it Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah and Muhammad. It's a name, but in reality that name is a name of someone. So when you want to raise someone, you raise him with his name, not you raise the name alone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as his servant, dedicated servant to Allah, that he had no more shirk. He raised him above the level of anything to understand and to realize the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why he said, man ittaba'ani faqad ahabbani. You cannot love someone without following that one. If you have a father and you don't follow your father or your mother, you don't love them. When you follow them, you love them. If we follow Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, means we love him. When we love him, what do you think? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah. Means if you love Muhammad and you follow Muhammad, I love you, O my servant. Don't come to me and say, I love you. No, you love first Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You love my servant first. You love him first. You show respect to him first. Then I show you respect. Don't come without respecting Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I will not open my door for you. Sahaba to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companion, they are the stars. They are the stars that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave, like the sun, and around the sun you can see these stars in the universe at night. They are the reflection of that light of the sun. They are the reflection of what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told them. He raised them to the level to become his companion. And when they asked him about, when he was mentioning Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was saying, أفضل الأمة أخير الأمة آخر الأمة. The best of the Ummah, the honored of the Ummah is the last one that comes before the days, the signs of the last days are the best. They said, Ya Rasulullah, what they are? They are Prophet? He said, no. They are more important to us? He said, no. He said, you are my Sahaba, you are my friends, but they are my lovers. They accepted Iman without seeing me. You saw me and you accepted Iman. They saw me, they didn't see me and they accepted me. They came through my love. They loved me. When they loved me, that love raised them up. We are lovers of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but Sahaba are honored to be Sahabas of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O Muslims, plant that love in the heart of your children. Don't let your children to be losing the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. Make it to them in their faces the picture of to picture Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the hero of this universe, because he is the hero of this universe. And what Ibn Mas'ud said in the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, and it is narrated in Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, he said, in kuntum tuhibbun tafsir, the explanation of the ayah, in kuntum tuhibbun Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum Allah, if you really love Allah, follow me, follow Prophet Allah who loves you. He said, inna Allah ta'ala nadara fi kulubi al-ibad fawajada qalba Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam khayra kulubi al-ibad. Allah looked into the hearts of his creation, and the heart of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the best, the unique one, because he perfected him. Allah perfected that heart. Fastafa, he picked him up, he raised him. When you stafa someone, you pick that, you raise that, you take it, you take him up from everyone else, you exclude him higher to take him up to the higher level. فَاصْطَفَاهُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَابْتَعَثَهُ بِرِسَالَتِهِ. He took him to himself because he know what he created. He created him perfect. So he sent him as a seals of messengers. And then when Mas'ud continues, ثُمَّ نَظَرَ فِي قُلُوبِ الْعِبَادِ فَوَجَدَ قُلُوبِ أَصْحَابِهِ خَيْرَ قُلُوبِ الْعِبَادِ. He looked into the heart of a human being. He found the hearts, the hearts of the Sahaba of Prophet were the best of all human beings. فَجَعَلَهُمْ وُزَرَاءَ لِنَبِيِّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He made them ministers or khalifas. He made them khalifas to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave them to Prophet. He said, these are the one that you depend on, 124,000 sahabi, as Ibn Abbas mentioned. يُقَاتِلُونَ عَنْ دِينِهِ means they try their best to keep Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala name and Allah's ibadah to be to him, the oneness to Allah, to not to associate anyone to with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That doesn't mean, as today these square-headed people, they understand it, means you respect Sayyidina Muhammad as much as you like, give him a higher and higher respect, no problem, as long as you say he is Allah's servant and Allah is the creator. If Allah raised him to this higher level, we cannot honor him by mentioning these higher levels. Whatever you want, Imam al-Busayri said, say as much as you want describing Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but don't say as the non-Muslim said about Sayyidina Isa. But say what you want.
فما رأه المسلمون فهو عند الله حسن وما رأه المسلمون سيئا فهو عند الله سيئا. Muslims means the Sahaba, the majority أهل السنة والجماعة, whom they have the love of Sayyidina Muhammad in their hearts. Whatever they see correct is correct. Whatever they see it's wrong, it's wrong. Don't destroy what Prophet liked. If you destroy what the Prophet liked, Allah will destroy you. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing the Muslims. Because they destroyed what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loved. He loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are not committing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And everyone loved his house. You love your house. He loves his house. She loves her house. You love the place where you were born. You love the place where you got married and you have your children. If you don't respect the house of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and your death rooms, that is so great, and not one Muslim leader spoke up. They destroyed, they demolished the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the house where he got married with Sayyida Khadija. And he got his 7 children from her. And the 3 boys died, and she had four daughters. They destroyed that in Safa and Marwa, Noah Safa and Marwa. And then what they did there, they made it restrooms. Did you spoke up? Anyone spoke up? Forget about us. Anyone Muslim leader spoke up? No one.
Allahu Akbar.
They are destroying today his birthplace.
Allahu Akbar.
Demolishing his birthplace. On what evidence? No evidence. Or from Quran and Sunnah that it is haram. Any Muslim standing up? Where are the Muslims? If we are doing what Prophet ﷺ has built, they built his house, we are destroying. We are not going to destroy his Sunnah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep the love of Sayyidina Muhammad in our hearts. And may Allah bless you to do these Milad al-Nabi conferences everywhere. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala support the Muslim Ummah. Wa min Allahi at-tawfiq. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.